So did you know that the worldwide amount of data currently doubles approximately every 2 years? This is impressive and frightening alike, isn't it? Combine this with the challenge of fighting global warming, of handling a partly connected refugee crisis, and of leveraging advances in artificial intelligence, and it becomes pretty obvious that rethinking our future, the topic of today's conference, is of literally vital importance. In addition to these major challenges the world currently faces, we often have the impression that we are permanently asked to work harder and faster, to do more, and to constantly adapt to ongoing and profound changes in our everyday lives. But is society today, now, really changing faster than before? After all, we're currently talking about the fourth industrial revolution, which kind of implies that before there have already been three other ones. And indeed, we, that is the press, media, people, we love to talk about profound transformations, even disruptions. And as usually, while change is driven by young generations, their parents and grandparents will feel that the world has gone crazy, making change appear to take place exponentially. However, instead of exponential, we rather should talk about periodic, groundbreaking changes. Radical transformation already took place several times in the past, with society and individuals alike who had to rethink their future. Already Heraclitus, a Greek philosopher, stated some 500 years before Christ that the only constant in life is change. Just think about when cars started to be mass produced in the beginning of the 20th century. Lots of horses consequently got an appointment at the butcher's, since they lost their main occupation as load carriers and coach pullers. And when sound was added to movies in the late 1920s, many of Hollywood's silent movie stars also lost their jobs, luckily without being sent to the meatpacking district. And finally, when internet conquered the world, I myself have one or two anecdotes to tell, although I like to think that I'm not that old yet. But indeed, in the beginning of my master's studies, I did not realize that administration would send emails. Actually, I did not even realize that I had an email account. And as such, for months, I did not get any information, puzzled where my fellow students got all their instructions from. Obviously, you could say I was just way ahead of my times. A pioneer of, sorry to say, today's students also not checking their emails. And talking about pioneer, today's host, ESCP Business School, my employer, as well as alma mater, the European School of Commerce Paris, naturally comes to my mind. Currently, everybody talks about higher education's digitalization, accentuated by COVID-19, potentially leading to the sector's disruption. But when ESCP was founded in 1819 as the world's first business school, yes, indeed, we invented the concept of the business school some 200 years ago. This invention was also seen as a major disruptor of the higher education landscape. And when the school started to open campuses next to Paris, also in London, in Germany, later on in Madrid, Turin, Warsaw, yet again, a new product of its kind was created. All this maybe puts the innovative magnitude of a class taught via Zoom into perspective. And change definitely has to be put into perspective. If it was true that society changes now faster than before, then it's also true that we can learn about such change at a much faster pace. Information is abundant. Not everybody immediately got to see an automobile when they first hit the roads. If the invention happened today, we probably would just go onto YouTube and watch a video about it. And talking about YouTube, we thought it was terrible that people stop watching videos after 90 seconds until the arrival of TikTok, where a necessary 15-second attention span already seems to be a burden. And on the contrary, Netflix allows for longer movies, even longer than 2 hours in length, kind of breaking this, let's say, maximum 90-minute convention across the movie theaters, increasingly having optimized their occupation rates and revenues over time. All these changes have an impact on our own lives, and often we complain about the difficulties induced by these magnetic powers or transformative powers. But most of the times it's rather about personal choices and how we encounter change. Do we embrace it? Do we fear it? Do we avoid it? When life is great, we definitely do not want anything to change. However, when it is bad, we cannot wait for change to happen. So in the end, maybe it is a question, even ideological in its nature, how we deal with change, how we embody change to reach personal happiness, ultimate goal in life, how we embrace change and transform it in line with our values into opportunities for us and for society at large, obviously. And with these open questions, I happily hand over to a series of very exciting speakers and wish you a fantastic and inspirational and above all life-changing and transformative conference.